Hello friends, welcome you once again in lecture series Machining Science and Machine Tool. Today I discussed the Unit 2 on Lecture 3. I am Amit Tiwari, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Suresh Janvier University, Jaipur. So today topic of the lecture is Theory on Mechanics of Metal Cutting. So let us start. The objective of today's lecture is to train the student in the metal cutting domain so as to equip them with adequate knowledge about the various processes like turning, shaping, planing, drilling, milling, and grinding. Second is to emphasize upon the prominent theory, concept, and construction features of machine related to them. The outcomes of the lectures are as follows. Student will able to find out forces on material with the help of orthogonal and oblique cutting. Second is to understand the angle of chip flow deviation. These are the some outcomes at the end of the lecture. Student will able to find this. Now the basically they're studying the theory of mechanism of metal cutting. So there are the lot of the theories are having the for mechanism of mechanics of metal cutting. So first of all we identify that is what is the mechanics of metal cutting. Because before we do not understand the mechanics of metal cutting, we do not understand that some theories are occur, some theories and some laws are having for the cutting through metal cutting. So what the metal cutting? Metal cutting is basically just we can say that the removal of material from the workpiece with the help of the cutting tool and the formation of the chip or the output of the removal of workpiece removal. That is, we can say that the metal will remove when the tool force act on the plane of workpiece, the shear plane, and start the material from removal and the formation of the chip are start. With the chip are formed, that is a completely removal of material and it completely converted into a plastic resin, which is not recovered by the removal of the tool again and to convert the again the box. That is, we can say that the mechanics of metal cutting. So mechanics that we can say that there are different types of forces acting along the surface of chip, acting along the surface of tool, or we can say that the surface of the workpiece also. So there are some frictional forces, some tensional forces, compressive forces, or we can say that the normal forces are acting on the forces of acting on the surface of chip, surface of tool, and surface of workpiece also. So there are too much type of forces are available. So with the help of these, we can identify the different type of forces. That is, if you can identify the cutting forces, so you can find out with the help of cutting formula, you can find out the thickness ratio of a particular chip. That is, you can find out the original thickness if you have having known, and you can find out the final chip thickness. That is the difference between the mechanism metal cutting and how you can find out the values of a particular area, particular tools for the identify which is the best for the mechanics of cutting. So the reason we identify, there are the three reasons, that is a shear plane, shear zone, or we can say that the workpiece area. So the shear plane occur where the maximum amount of we can say the removal of material are occur and the heat plastic formation are held on, this type of phenomena. We can say that also the shear plane is also the responsible for to remove the material with the help of the cutting tool and the formation of the chip also. So for that there are the too much amount of a compressive force acting on the plane, acting on the plane of the compressive chip along the direction of the tool cutting. Because we must be know that most of the cutting parameters, that is the cutting speed, fluidity, and depth of cut, when you are increasing and decreasing these parameters, you can observe that during the tool striking on the surface of workpiece and at the cutting edge, increasing too much amount of compressive forces acting on the plane. So these compressive forces are the responsible to remove the material because it will change the we can say change the microstructure, or we can help to remove the material from the tool and convert in the chip with the formation. So this type of problems are generally occurs, and you can find out with the help of some theory like is merchant theory, and we can say find out some shear stress plan and shear angle theory. So these all are the helpful for the find out the mechanics of the metal cutting. So we can say that from the various relationship derived above, we find that they involve alpha rack angle, beta friction angle, and psi is equal to shear angle. The angle alpha on the tool can be easily measured, but the value of beta and phi can be obtained by the computation. So the optional is that if you find out the rake angle alpha, that you can find be easily. Okay, it is easy to find alpha angle, but if you find the friction angle and the shear angle, then it is very difficult to identify then the from the physical or experimental way. So you could need to some computational, with the help of some computational, you will be able to find out this type of value. So several investigators such as Ernst and Merchant, Stabler, Lee and Schaeffer, Plammer and Oxley, having carried out lot of work to establish the relation between the alpha, beta and psi, and have proposed their own theories. So there are the different authors are having, and they all have proposed their own theory related to the work relationship between the alpha rack angle, beta friction angle and psi the shear angle. So these are the some role play of each and every angle. That is, alpha is responsible basically, we know, at the rack angle. So we must be identified that the rake angle is most important, because with the rake angle increasing, or we can have the positive rake angle, it means that the machining is good, it means that the metal removal is good, and the overall phenomena is good for the metal cutting. Because the rake angle is responsible for that, larger the rake angle or positive the rake angle, it will have to understand better the machining operation, and the chip formation will be continuous, will be over. So when the rack angle, that is alpha, is decreasing or having the less number of area be covered, but so during this time the metal are not completely, we can say that metal cutting is not completely done, because most of the metal are just occur with the help of some certain parameters. Some certain parameters are alpha. First of all, this alpha is the rack angle. It's very important, as I am saying already. Because we know that during the metal cutting, we must be reminded and keep in mind that alpha angle almost positive. In the case of beta, that is the frictional angle, the frictional angle occur when the friction axis of increasing the too much amount of heat, that is from the compressive area, FC. So with the help of compressive force, the more amount of friction will be generated. If we reduce the compressive force, with the help of reducing the depth of cut, because if you increase the too much depth of cut, to maintain the cutting, we need to maintain the cutting parameter. If you maintain the cutting parameter, you should keep the surface safe. So what we do, that is, if you increase in the depth of cut, it is responsible to increase in the compressive stress, and during the compressive stress, the load of friction are generated, and the friction that we consider the shear friction angle are occur, and which be responsible for burn the surface of the chip, and we can say that it is also a good responsible for the increasing to remove the chip from the workpiece metal. So when you have to identify that Lee and Schaeffer theory, or because there are different types of theories having for the purpose of their own for relation find out between the alpha, beta and psi. So with the help of this, we will understand that there are different types of. First of all, we understand that it is Ernst and Merchant theory. So what they said, we just the following assumption, they are of the, this theory is based on the following assumptions. The first is the shear stress is maximum at the shear plane. Shear stress is maximum at the shear plane, and it remains constant. So there are some assumptions. So before starting the discussing the some Merchant theory, first of all you need to get some following assumptions we keep in mind. So the first assumption, it is that the shear stresses is maximum at the shear plane and the remain constant. So it may be chances that in shear plane either the shear stress is maximum, or it may be said that it is remain constant. There is no implementations of no increment or no decrement on the shear stresses with the surface of the shear plane. So these are the first assumption. Second is the expenditure is minimum in this process. So the expenditure is minimum in this process. So that is, the shear will take place in the direction in which the energy required for shearing is minimum. So the second point we covered, that is the expenditure is minimum in this process. So they proposed the theory where the expenditure in this process is minimum having, because that is the shear will take place in the direction which the energy required for shearing is minimum. So we will take the we can the shearing of a direction of energy required for the shearing is minimum, where the minimum and shearing is required at the time the energy will reduce with the, because we do not work a more amount of energy will produce for that particular removal of sharing of material. So it is very good assumptions that we can consider in the Hurst-Merchant theory. Now the FT, we can find out the tangential force, or we can also say the cutting forces. The formula is equal to FT is equal to R, that is resultant, cos beta minus alpha, beta that is the frictional forces minus rectangle, FS that is shear force, R is cos theta divided by phi plus beta minus alpha. Phi is equal to shear plane, shear angle we consider, beta is equal to friction angle, and alpha is equal to rectangle. FT divided by FS, when you put the value of FT and FN divided by section, so we can find out the FT is equal to FS. FT is equal to FS. So we can put the value, we can cross multiply to the value, and we can find out the value FT. So from the put the value like this, and so FT is equal to FS into cos beta minus alpha divided by cos beta theta plus beta minus alpha in the bracket. So we can put the value of FS. This FS, we can put the value, that is a tau dot p into t divided by sine phi. You can put the value of this fs into the this formula, so you will finally you can get the ft is equal to tau dot p into t divided by sine theta cos beta minus alpha divided by cos beta plus alpha minus alpha. So you can find out the value of ft here. Now differentiate equation 1, that is it is a equation number 1, you can finally got out equation number 1. And differentiate equation number 1 with respect to, we can say that the right phi and equating to 0 phi and equating to 0 to find the value of shear angle. Okay, to differentiate the equation number 1 with respect to time and phi and equating to 0 to find the value of shear angle phi, for which the FT is the minimum we get. FT is the minimum we get. FT, that means the tangential force or the cutting force is the minimum. Okay, for finding out the value of the shear angle phi. So the differential, that is we can do the differential, that is the dFT divided by d phi is equal to tau dot b dot t cos beta minus alpha under bracket. You can put the all the values here. Cos dot cos phi dot cos beta theta phi plus beta minus alpha minus sine phi dot sine phi plus beta minus alpha divided by sine phi into cos beta theta plus beta minus alpha square. So you can put the value all the here at the principle, and cos multiply to we can put the value. You can decide here the other in the question, you can put the value from like this, and cos theta, you can say cos theta dot b cos theta plus beta minus alpha, you can put the value like this. Minus sign, you can put the upper value like this, and all the values are remaining in this, we can compare the 0. Cos beta plus cos theta plus beta minus alpha is equal to 0. So you can put the value remaining time and the freaking formula. And you can put the 2 phi plus phi, it is a 2 phi plus beta minus alpha is equal to cos phi by 2. So 2 phi plus beta minus alpha is equal to pi by 2, and the phi value is equal to pi by 4 minus beta divided by 2 plus alpha by 2, and the shear angle you can find out the phi is equal to pi by 4 minus 1 by 2 minus beta minus 2. So you know, so it is the Hurst-Merchant circle theory. You can find out the phi, that is a shear angle, with the help of this formula pi by 4. Whenever you must you just need to find out the two value, that is beta, that is a frictional, we can find out the value, and we can say the frictional value, and other the rectangle. So with the help of it, you will be able to find out, you can find out this value. You can find out first of all this value, we get the help of this. So you need to the beta value, that is, we can say that the fractional angle, if you having, and if you having the right angle, so you will easily find out the value of shear angle phi. So with the this, you will be able to understand that beta and beta minus alpha. So basically, we obtain the value from the, if we minus the beta fractional value minus the right angle, because as obviously that if the fraction angle, that is we can say that how much amount of value angle are from the fractional side, and the right angle, that is larger the right angle, larger the value we having the for the good machinability, and if the fractional angle is more and it is not required, that is we required the minimum surface shearing area, because minimum time taken, it is about some assumptions required. If we working on this particular plan, it will be definitely will easy to understand this type of phenomena in our direction of arch merchant theory. So these are the arch merchant theory. I hope you understand. So if you need doubt, then we will discuss it later. So the next is the merchant theory. Next is the merchant theory. That is, the merchant found that the above theory agree well with experimental results obtained when cutting synthetic plastic, but agree poorly with experimental result obtained for steel machine with this trinitrile carbide tool. So the merchant circle, merchant theory, that we can say that the theory, merchant found that the above theory agree well with experimental results obtained when cutting synthetic plastic, but agree poorly with experimental result obtained for steel machine with a trinitrile carbide tool. The merchant then modify his theory by assuming that the shear stress tau along the shear plane very relatively with the normal stresses, that is we can say that tau is equal to tau 0 plus k sigma, where k is constant, sigma is equal to shear stress. Okay, so tau 0 is the value of tau when sigma is 0. Tau 0 is the value of tau. Okay, so you can put the value of tau in the place of sigma, tau 0, that is tau is the value of tau 0. Tau 0 is the value of tau, and where the when the value of tau 0 is the tau when the sigma is 0. Okay, this assume agree with the working of Bridgman, where in experiment on polycrystal lined metals, the shear metal strength can shown to be dependent on the normal stresses on the plane of the shear merchant than the drive. 2 beta plus 2 phi plus beta minus alpha is equal to C. So this formula obtained from the merchant, a head drive, for the normal plane of the shear, where C is the machining constant, R cot K, where C is the machining constant, its value varying from the 70 to 80 degree for the various steels, and depending upon the different conditions, what the type of steel we used. Okay, so it vary basically the range of 70 to 80 degree. Okay, we consider for the various steels. Most recent experimentally work indicate that tau remain constant for a given material over a wide range of cutting conditions, and therefore K would be expected to be zero. Obviously, that you can find out the basically in the experimental work that indicated tau we can say that remain constant for a given material over the wide range of cutting condition, and therefore K will be expected to be zero. So this all are the conditions having occur for the merchant theory. Whenever you are doing metal cutting, so just keep in mind that merchant theory indicate that the assuming that the shear stresses tau along with the shear plane vary linearly with the normal stresses, that is tau is equal to tau 0 plus k sigma, where k is constant, and just remember that tau 0 is the value of tau when the sigma is 0. So sigma is 0 is the most important condition to be occur. If sigma must be 0, then this condition not be suitable for this, because this condition happening only when the sigma is 0. So you can find out the final value, that is 2 theta minus plus beta minus alpha is equal to c, where the c is the machining constant. Okay, so I hope you understand. There is some merchant theory. Now what that we consider Stabler theory, he modified the Ahrensohn equation, that is the phi is equal to pi by 4 minus beta plus alpha by 2. What is the Ahrensohn equation? That is the equation like this: pi is equal to pi by 4 minus 1 by 2 beta minus alpha, and it is modified by the Stabler theory, it is pi by 2 minus beta plus alpha by 2. So these are the Ahrensohn theory. Some modifications are having the doing some research, and that we can find out the finally the modified Ahrensohn equation and Stabler theory are formed. Now we follow the some Stabler theory for the find out the shear angle. So whenever you find out the some shear angle, you do not to put this value, because these are the some older value and these are the modified values. So the shear angle you can find out with the help of this. So with the this formula, these are the some older formula and these are the some recent new formula developed by the Stabler theory, is modified the Ahrensohn equation. Okay, so whenever you find out the shear angle, you can put this formula: phi is equal to pi by 4 minus beta plus alpha by 2. Now next is the Lee and Schaeffer theory, indicate that the Lee and Schaeffer obtained a solution to the problem of the mechanics of orthogonal cutting by using the slip line field theory. He said that the Lee and the Schaeffer obtain a solution to the problem of the mechanics of orthogonal cutting by using the slip line field theory. What is the theory? That this theory is based on the ideal theory of plasticity, according to which shear occur on the shear single plane. What the theory occur? What the theory is? That this theory is based on the ideal theory of plasticity, according to which shear occur on the single plane. The solution has been derived from the pattern of construction of a slip line field using a shear plane model. The plane, the figure I show here. They assume that there must be stress field within the chip to constrict the cutting forces from the shear plane to the tool faces. They represent this by a slip field in which no deformation occur all through. It is stressed upon the yield point. This show the Mohr circle for the stresses at the boundary and the stresses zone, which results in the equations. The first of all, what we showed, it is the some conditions are occur in this theory, based on basically the, we can say that the ideal theory of plasticity, according to which shear occur on the single plane. The shear occur on single plane, that we can say that the you can say these are the workpiece area. You can the bottom, this is workpiece area, and the tool is present on the workpiece and is starting to the remove the material from the workpiece and the convert the chip is the chip formation. Where you can see each and every element, you can say each and every one is a 5 by 4. Each and every one is 5 by 4. That is, we can say the LMQ, and this is a 5. This is a shear plane. You can say this is a 5. That is a shear plane. So you can find out the shear angle with the help of this phi angle. You can find out the value of shear angle. Okay, and the velocity, the cutting velocity V is like this. So these are the operations we have performed. What we do, that is phi is equal to pi by 4 plus beta minus alpha. So here the conditions are changed. That is, if you find out the phi, it is the shear angle. That is pi by 4 plus alpha. That is the rag angle minus the frictional, we can say the frictional angle. Okay, and another formula you can obtain by further extend, that is phi is equal to pi by 4 minus beta plus alpha minus theta. Beta plus alpha minus theta, you can find out the formula like this. So these are the some formula we can obtain by the merchant, we can the Lee and Schaeffer theory prefer. Now the fifth is Christopherson, Oxley and Plamer theory. According to this, during the detailed study, they found that the grain flow show a streamlined pattern, and that the boundary between elastic and plastic zone was not a straight line, but in narrow wedge shafts. So he found that during the investigation that the grain flow show a streamline pattern, that the boundary between the elastic and the plastic zone was not a straight line but a narrow wedge shaft broken on the surface of buckwheat. These are the some inventions are done by the Christofferson and Oxley and Plamer theory according to this. Now sixth one is the empirical approach. Sixth one is empirical approach. That is the one classical example of empirical approach is dimensional analysis, which is extensively used in fluid mechanics and has been used successfully applied to some problem in metal cutting by Kornberg. I'm just repeat once again. It is the empirical approach is one of the most popular theory which we adopted. It is a one classical example of empirical approach, dimensional analysis. It is dimensional analysis which is extremely used in fluid mechanics, obviously, and having some successfully applied to some examples of problems in metal cutting by Kornberg. So the above approach has been tried to get a suitable relationship for the shear angle, and again, of course, assuming a thin shear plane at the shear zone corresponding to most of the practical high speed system. So basically it is based on the dimensional analysis, and the following the two equations have been derived from the empirical approach. That is first is the beta phi divided by beta is equal to k, phi divided by beta is equal to k divided, we can say that phi divided by beta to power a and f divided by a to power d b. And the second is the phi divided by b is equal to k1 cos alpha to power a alpha 1 and f upon d to power b1, where k a b k l a1 and b1 are the empirical constant to be studied from the data of experiment. So these all are the some we can say these all are the theory of a mechanics of a metal cutting. And on the basis of the theory of metal cutting, you must keep in mind that each and every theory indicate that the shear plane, because the shear plane, we can find out the shear angle, and shear angle is basically because we find out because of the material removal rate, material will start to remove and it convert the their zone from the plastically completely with the help of the formation of chip. So shear plan of shear angle, that is the most important to identify. And for the shear angle we identify, you must be reminded that the two type of angle where you have you having the value with the help of you can find out the shear angle, that is the sectional angle and the rake angle. Both are important. Sectional angle will have to identify the frictional register occur at the surface of the chip, and the rake angle will occur during the cutting tool. How much the rake angle, and if the larger the rake angle, it will be positive number. So these are the formula we can obtain from the find out the with the help of the convergence theory. So with the help of this, we can put the value and find out the value of FT. And we can find out the value of a shear angle. It is phi with the help of the formula pi by 4 minus 1 by 2 beta minus alpha. So in this all the obtained, you can find out the value of beta minus alpha is the most important, the frictional angle and the alpha angle. If you are having that, you will be able to find out the shear angle, and if that is a phi. Okay. Another one, this is the Rasmussen theory. It is proposed some type of work that is experimentally based. Okay, so study will be also doing some work, experimental work on steel. So that is we can find out the various type of steel. So the measuring constant that we can set at the vary from the 70% to 80%, that is for the various steels. So what type of steel used, it is depending upon the thermal conditions. And second we can set at the Lee and Schaeffer theory, that is phi is equal to pi by 4 minus beta plus alpha by 2. That is Lee and Schaeffer theory are responsible for the obtained problem of the mechanics of the orthogonal cutting by using the slip field theory. So these are the some following theories are having. In the theory, what we do in the theory, we basically do the ideal theory of plasticity, according to which the shear occur on the single plane. The solution have been derived from the pattern of construction of slip line field using a shear plane model You can see this diagram, which is a model from the pattern of the construction of slip line field of shear plane. So you can must keep in mind the more circle for the stresses of the boundary of the stress zone, which is resulting equation like this. So you can find out the value from the this. We can put the value of from the formula and get the value of the shear angle by this. So these are the some different types of theories of the metal cutting which has to be keep in mind, because each and every theory are important as a point of view in an examination and interview will be asked during if you having the machining subject expertise or machining subject you have an interesting area. So there will be also some certain question and also competitive exam. This question will be fight for which type of theory are having the sub conditions, and you will be having some answers like Shaper theory, Lien theory, empirical approaches, crystallographic oxygen polymer theory. So what type of theory you having the for that? For you will be able to understand if you having the knowledge about this theory, you will be giving the answer of that particular question related to this. Okay. Now we can doing some numerical portion start for the orthogonal machining. We can cut the material and how we can find out the value. So we can put up some examples. That is example number one. While doing orthogonal machining of a mild steel part, at depth of cut we having the 0.75 mm and is used at the 60 rpm. If the chip thickness is 1.5 mm and it is of continuous type, then they determine first is chip thickness ratio. Second is the length of the chip removed in 1 minute if work diameter 60 mm before the cut is taken. So these are some conditions we want to determine. That is first chip thickness ratio determined, and the second one is the length for the of the chip removed in 1 minute if the work diameter is 60 mm before the cut is taken. So the solution we can say here that the given value is T is equal to 0.75 mm. N is equal to 60 rpm, TC is equal to 1.5 mm, and D is equal to 60 mm. These are the solutions we can send it as a given value in the questions. So with the help of this, easy to understand what we can find out and how we can find out. Second is the chip thickness ratio. First of all, we find out the chip thickness ratio R. In the formula of chip thickness ratio is equal to R is equal to T upon TC. T upon TC, that is 0.75 divided by 1.5. So both are having. So with the having this formula, R is equal to T upon TC. You will put the value of T and TC and divided by both the dividing, and after you can find out the value R is equal to 0.5. So you can put the value of T and TC from the given numerical, and you can find the value of R. It is 0.5, which is the answer of chip thickness ratio. Second, we can find out the length of the chip removed, that is TC. Length of the chip removed, that we can find out the length of the chip before cutting, that is the uncut chip thickness we can find out first of all. So L is equal to formula, L is equal to pi d n. L is equal to pi d into n. So what we have that the pi the value, standard value, d is equal to 60 we have for the RPM. And and we also we have the 60, so pi into 60 into 60 is equal to 11,309.7 mm per minute is the length. We can say that first of all we identify the length of the chip before cut, but then we can identify the that we can say that the LC, that is L is the we can be able to find out L 11,309.7 mm per minute. So we also know that the R is equal to T upon TC, then we can also replace by the T LC upon L, LC upon L. So we can find out the value of LC, that is LC is equal to R into L, R into L. So we have found out the value of R, also chip in ratio, and length of chip removed TC also. So we can first of all multiply the R into L, that is the chip thickness ratio multiplied by the length of the chip before cutting. So 0.5 into 11309.7, and the multiply after that you will find out the value of LC, the length of a chip removed is LC is equal to, we can find 5654.8 mm answer. So these are the answer of this question. That is, if we can find the two of the value, chip thickness ratio R from the r is equal to t upon t formula, and length of chip remove tc, that is we can find out when the l is equal to pi dn. That is we can say that we having we required having the diameter and required having the rpm. So with the help of this we can find out the value of l. Okay, so with the help of this, I'm this numerical will help to you understand how we can find out the chip thickness ratio and how we can find out the length of chip removed. If the some conditions are given, that is an if you having the diameter and as well as you having the rpm. So these are the some numerical. Second numerical we having, that is the example number 2. During the orthogonal cutting, a bar of 90 mm diameter is reduced to 87.6 mm. So during the orthogonal cutting, a bar of 90 mm diameter is reduced to 87.6 mm. If the mean length of the cut chip is 38.2 mm and the rack angle is 15 degrees. So calculate first is the cutting ratio and second is shear angle. So the given the values having the T is equal to LC, we have the value, we know the condition T is equal to LC is equal to 88.2 mm and alpha is equal to 15 degree. Alpha is equal to 15 degree. So first condition, that is we can find out cutting ratio R, we can find out the help of length of the uncut chip TC is equal to L. So the value having the pi is equal to pi into 90 plus the value of 87.6. Okay. We have diameter, so divide by 2 you can put the value of TC and you can find the value, that is 278.97 mm. Now second is the cutting ratio, that is R is equal to cut chip thickness, that is depth of cut divided by uncut chip thickness, T upon TC is equal to LC upon L. So you can put the value of LC, then we can find out with the given formula at double at 2.2 divided by, you can find out the value of put the value of L, that is we can find out the recently 278.97 and divided by divided both together and find the value of chip thickness ratio R is equal to 0.3162. And the second is the shear angle, you can find out the phi, that is we know that the phi formula is equal to 10 inverse is equal to phi is equal to 10 inverse bracket R cos alpha divided by 1 minus R sin alpha. So put all the values of R and alpha in the term where the mention, and you can find the value that you can phi shear phi angle is 18.4 is the correct answer. We can find out with the help of this formula. So with the help of formula, you can find out the two values, it's a cutting ratio and shear angle. It is very simple numerical. Just you can put the formula of certain mention above the terms, and at the sum with the help of some given values and the questions, you will easily to handle the formula. So you must be reminded that all the formula in mind, that what formula of the cutting angle cutting ratio we can find out R, and what the formula of a shear angle if you find out phi. So these all are the conditions are occur when you having the knowledge of the cutting mechanism of cutting parameter, and you can find out some formula also. So it will helpful to understand that all the parameters are working very easily, that there is no any complications are occur. So I hope you understand. The last and the third numerical, that is during the orthogonal machine with a cutting tool having a 12 rack angle, the chip thickness is measured to be 0.4 mm and the uncut thickness being 0.18 mm. Determine shear plane angle and second is shear stresses. So I'm going to repeat once again, the question is during a orthogonal machine with a cutting tool having a 12 degree rack angle, chip thickness is measured to be 0.4 mm. And the uncut chip thickness being 0.18 mm, and determine the two things, the two form, that is first is shear plane angle, second is the shear stress. So the you can find out, first of all, what is the given value to solve the answer to all the question. First to find out the given value, alpha is equal to 12 degree, TC is equal to 0.4 mm, T is equal to 0.18 mm, and you can put the first of all the value of shear angle plane to find out. Fine. First of all, we having not the R, that is we required a chip thickness ratio, because in the formula of pi we not at the R is required, so because we having not the R value, we have the alpha value but we do not have the R value. So we can first of all find the chip thickness ratio, but the chip thickness ratio we can find out by the formula with the R is equal to T upon TC, the T will be having and TC also be having, so you can divide by both the terms and we can put the value of R, that is the 0.41. And after you will put the value of R in the formula phi, that is the phi is equal to 10 inverse R cos alpha divided by 1 minus R sin alpha. So you can put the value of all the terms related to this formula, and you can finally solve this numerical calculations, and you can find the value of phi, that is the shear plane angle phi value is 23.67 degrees is the correct answer. So we can find out the shear plane angle for this condition. Second is shear stress equals sigma. Shear stress sigma, we can find out the formula cot phi plus 10 phi minus alpha. So you have the value, you can find out the phi because we required a phi value for the shear strength, and we have to find out phi is equal to 23.67, and the alpha value we having, that is the 12 degree. So you can put the all the value once again, and in this term, and you can find the calculator the value, and you can find the sigma value, that is a 2.4 at it. Answer the correct answer. So this is a simple numerical. You can put the value, and you can find out the all the answer in easy form. Now it's time to ask you some multiple choice question related to the today lecture. For how much you understand that today lecture. First of all, the first question is, in metal cutting, there are some calling conditions. That is the two condition is material removal is affected by relative motion between the two length of workpiece. B, material removal is not affected by relative motion between the two length of workpiece. So what condition is arrived for the metal cutting process? So the answer is A, that is the material removal is affected by relative motion between the two length of workpiece. So material will be affected, yes, definitely when the tool and the workpiece of relative motion are related together, and affected by the material will be affected by this. Okay, so and this is the A is the correct answer for the condition in metal cutting of process. Second question is the forces required for metal cutting operation. The options are A, that is the increasing in the feet of the tool and decreasing with increasing in the depth of the cut. B is equal to decreasing with increasing in the feet of the tool and increasing with increasing in the depth of the cut. T is increasing with increasing in both the feet and of the tool and the depth of cut. D is equal to decrease with increasing in both the feet of the tool and the depth of the cut. The correct answer of the question is C, that is increasing with increasing in both the feet of the tool and the depth of the cut. So these are the forces required for metal cutting operation. Third is the numerical, you can find out the value, that is calculate the power required for machining of workpiece on the lathe having efficiency of 85% of on full load when tangential force is required is 1200 newton and cutting speed is 195 meter per minute. So the correct the options there are, that is first option is 4.59 kilowatt, second 275.29 watt, third is 3.315 kilowatt, and D is the insufficient data, as not required. So after calculating, you can find out the value, that is the correct answer is A, that is 4.59 kilowatt is the correct answer of this question, it is the power required. Fourth is the fourth question, the point at which the cutting tool reaches beyond which it will not function satisfactory until it is regrounded is called as A is equal to tool wear, B is equal to tool failure, C is equal to tool diffusion, and D is equal to one of the above. The correct answer of the question is, it is B, that is a tool failure. We can say that the tool at which the point at which the cutting tool reaches and beyond which it will not affect function satisfactory until it is regrounded is called as the tool failure. Fifth question is, which cutting condition affected the cutting temperature predominated? Which cutting condition affected? We can say that the cutting temperature predominated. So the options are A is equal to depth of cut, B is equal to cutting speed, C is equal to feed rate, and D is equal to none of the above has any effect on the cutting temperature. So the correct answer of the question is B, that is the cutting speed. So basically we required, we did that the which condition cutting condition affected the cutting temperature predominantly, that is the cutting speed affected the the cutting temperature, because if you increase in the too much cutting speed, it generally increases the cutting temperature high. And with the also increasing the cutting speed, we must predict that quality of the finishing will be increasing by increasing the cutting speed. So the cutting speed is the right answer for the and the appropriate answer for the affecting the cutting temperature of the predominantly. Okay. Now the next question is, which type of chip from while machining of brittle material? Which type of chip form while machining of the brittle material? So the options are continuous chip, B discontinuous chip, C build-up chip, and D all of the above with some proportion. So the correct answer is that is discontinuous chip is the answer of this question. We required that we generally know that the brittle material having cases of formation of the discontinuous chip, because in ductile material we having the continuous form and for the good machinability. So we require the good if we say a good machining surface and surface quality be obtained from the brittle material. But in the case of discontinuous chip based form, and there are some disadvantages of brittle material, because it easily break when the cutting forces or cutting we can say that force are acting on that material, it will be break sometime. Seventh is we can say that discontinuous chip are formed during the machining of, the options are brittle metal, B ductile metal, C hard metal, and D soft metal. So the correct answer of the question is A, that is brittle metal is the discontinuous chip are formed during the machining of brittle metal. So obviously that when the brittle metal is having and the lot of understand that much more parameter. If you are acting on the surface of brittle metal, it will be easily break and discontinuous formation of chip will be occur. So these are some advantages of brittle material. And if you want to reduce the brittle material, we will join the chip breaker of instrument of the tool of the surface of the tool for stopping the discontinuous chip. Or we can use the metal of that becomes the brittle material, except the ductile metal we use for continuous chip formation. So the correct answer of the question is that is the discontinuous chip are formed during the machining of brittle metal. Eighth question is, which of the following parameter govern the value of the shear angle in continuous leaf formation? The question is, which of the following parameter govern the value of the shear plane in continuous chip formation? The correct options are A true feed, B chip thickness, C rack angle of the cutting tool, and D all of the mention. So the correct answer of this is D, that is all of the mention are correct for the condition. So the option I'm repeating once again to understand better, that is which of the following parameters govern the value of the shear angle in continuous chip formation. So all the conditions are true, that is a true feed value, chip thickness also responsible, and rack angle of the cutting tool is all are the three parameters are responsible for the govern the value of shear angle in continuous chip formation. Ninth is in metal cutting machining, the zone where the heat is generated. The zone where the heat is generated due to the friction, due to the friction between the moving chip and the tool face is called, options are friction zone, B work tool contact zone, C shear zone, and the D is none of the mention. I'm just repeat once again, in which machining the zone where the heat is generated due to friction between the moving chip and the tool face is called, the options are face friction zone, B work tool contact zone, C shear zone, and D none of the mention. So the correct answer of the question is A, that is a friction zone. We can say that in metal machining, the zone where the heat is generated due to friction between the moving chip and the face tool is called the friction zone. And the last multiple choice question, that is 10th, is the ratio of the cutting force to the cross sectional being cut. The ratio of the cutting forces to the cross sectional area being used is called, the options is A specific cutting force, B thrust force, C frictional force, and D none of the mention. So the correct answer of the question is A, that is we can say the specific cutting forces. So the option we can say cutting force are the ratio of cutting force to the cross sectional area being cut. So the specific cutting force is the answer of this question. And basically, during this lecture, I am just going to say that there are the theories of metal cuttings you must keep in mind, and having the knowledge of each and every theory which is responsible for the cutting operations, and will provide to you the good machinability, and as well as you provide some knowledge about the find out the shear plan area or shear angle cutting ratio, or as we can find out the frictional angle and the shear angle. So it's very helpful to understand to verify the value, and when you are doing the numerical, you can find the value. So textbooks are I'm giving at the end of the lecture, and for preparing this lecture or for making this lecture easily to understand, or we can find out the some numericals for the respective topic with the help of this book. That is the book name here, Modern Machining Science, written by the P.C. Pandey and H.S. Shah from the Tata McGraw Hills. Machine tool designed from by the N.K. Mehta from Tata McGraw Publisher. Third is the Production Engineering Science, P.C. Pandey and C.K. Singh, Standard Publisher Limited. Fourth, Manufacturing Technology, R.K. Rajput, Lakshmi Publications. And Machine Manufacturing Technology, P.N. Rao from the Tata McGraw Publisher. So these all are the very popular books and popular authors written by this, and where the popular publishers are here for have a good rating. So you will prefer these books for understanding the machining science and machine tool subject in with the numerical form also. So I hope you enjoy this video, and I hope you any doubt and any question, whatever the question has in mind related into today's lecture, you will be dropping a mail on my email ID, that is amit.tiwari@mygenva.com, and you will be also dropping a mail of the same question. I will be trying to solve this, and you will contact me on my mobile number also 8690 319448. I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you so much for listening patiently. Thank you.